we record that broadcast on the internet feed at www.wrpi.org. Here we're at the Houston Fieldhouse, live coverage of RPI against Harvard. At the Gary and Joe Piscana here on the call for you on your home for Indian Hockey, 91.5 FM WRPI Troy. And Joe, thank you for updating the women's score before the anthem.
Yeah, it's a big weekend for them. It's their first playoff weekend, and we're going to talk about this a little during the intermission, but their engineers goalie, Lovisa Solander, has been nominated for the Patty Kazmaier Award, which is essentially the Heisman of women's hockey, or the Hobey Baker of women's college hockey. It's given to the best player in the NCAA, as voted by the fans, the media, as well as the other players. And so she's certainly doing her part tonight. And she's got a shutout through the first period and plus. And we, as we get set to face off here in the Fieldhouse, Moore takes the face off, won back by the Crimson. Adam Fox with it, the Hobey Baker nominee. He dumps it deep, swings it around the boards. Riley will take it back for the Engineers. Harvard trying to start a cycle. Engineers trying to clear. Sent in, glove down by Savory very easily.
Yeah, and, 1940 left to play in the first. No score, RPI Harvard. Light crowd here. Of course, the students on break. The townie section, spattered with people. But, of course, there's two big concerts in downtown Albany tonight. There's a Grateful Dead tribute concert at the Palace.
Wow.
And then Elton John's, his last tour ever, stops in Albany tonight. His Farewell Yellow Brick Road tour stops in Albany tonight. So, plenty of competition for RPI tonight.
Yeah, but a big weekend nonetheless for the Engineers here. As we stated earlier, they are fighting for some home ice here as it is sent in by the Crimson. Riley swings it around the boards for Gornal. Gornal loses it through his legs, and the Crimson push back in. Take it by the ECAC hockey logo, and they'll dump it back to the far corner. Riley again with it. Swings it up to Johnson. Johnson tries swinging it up the boards, but it's held in. Morello with it now. Sends it across the crease. Skating up with it now is Riley. Riley will send it over to Gornal. Gornal puts it in the corner, near corner. Engineers change. Crimson push out. Now moving up with it is Drury. Drury swings down the near side. Looking for a trailer. Sends a shot in on Savory, who decides to not cover and drops back for Tommy Grant. Grant swings up to Morello. Morello again outlets. Finds Lepinen. Lepinen having a pretty good freshman campaign, but he gets knocked off the puck. Taken now by Olsen. Olsen will send it over to Bachman. Bachman will send it in, but it's taken out by Tommy Grant along the bench. Engineers is playing in the neutral zone, really, with the Crimson. Not too much spacing here for either team. Taken out by Krusko in the near corner. He'll circle around with it. That's Bedini with it now. He's getting pushed off in the corner, and the Engineers escape with it. Tor Linden moves through center ice. He tries to find Lepinen. Sends it behind the net. Crimson battle back to take it. Now skating up with it is Fox. He'll send it cross ice. Hallbauer retreats to get it. He'll swing around his own net, picks up some speed and skates up. Gets knocked off the puck in front of his own bench, and we have a whistle.
17:58 left to play in the first. No score, RPI and Harvard. Of course, Owen Savory making some good save shots, 2-0 in favor of Harvard right now. So Owen Savory, making the saves that he has to save. And we will resume in a moment.
And now we've got Polino and Hayhurst on the ice for the first time. And there's actually a hooking penalty on Jack Donato. So the Engineers are going on the power play. Hallbauer sends it over to Hayhurst. Hayhurst drops it back to Hallbauer. Hallbauer sends it through, bounces around, out of the goal mouth. Engineers keep it in for the moment, and it gets sent down by Drury. Savory takes behind his own net. Pressing there was Floodstrand, but the Engineers come back out. Polino stick handling. Gets it taken off his stick, and they clear again, but it's stopped by Hallbauer at center ice. Engineers retreat and reset. Hallbauer sends it up to Burgess, takes it off his skate. That sends it to Polino near the circle, and it gets taken off his stick, but now it bounces off, ricochets over to Hayhurst, who sets it up at the point for Whiffen. Hayhurst gets back to the point, looks for Hallbauer. Hallbauer, slap shot, gets through, but it's covered by Gournette.
Yeah, we didn't see the referee raise his arm for the penalty on that last one, but nonetheless, as they just showed the replay right now, and yep, just as Hallbauer was skating around the net, Donato just got him with the hook. 17:06 left to play in the first, no score, RPI and Harvard.
Lepinen set to take the face off for the Engineers. Gets it over to Laka. Laka sends it to the point for Shane Bear. Shane Bear plays with Riley at the point. Riley gets a wrister that goes through. Blocked aside by Grenet. Engineers starting to create some pressure with this power play. Riley takes it again by the circle. Back up to the point for Bear. Over to Riley for the slapper. Pushed aside by Grenet. All these shots are right on target where they should be. Riley sends it to the far point for Burgess. Back over to Bear. Over to Riley. Riley sends it through. Bounces around. Ricochets. He scores! Chase Seeky! And that's his eighth goal of the season on the rebound. Chase Seeky puts it home for the Engineers to take a 1-0 lead. 16:35 to go in the first.
Well, I like what I saw on our RPI power play. Not only were they cycling the puck very well, they had a screen out in front, which is a lot more than what we saw in the past for RPI. They had a man screening out in front. They had Laka and Zeke on either wing. So the goalie was screened and he was kicking up the rebounds to either side. So a good job by Coach Smith noticing that Gornet was kicking up the rebounds. Laka just bounced over his stick a few times, and that time Zeke got it right on his stick and in the back of the net.
And they score first, and that's a huge deal because Coach Smith talked about working on the power play actually in your pregame interview. So that's what you like to see. You like to see them coming away with it. Now as Tommy Grant strides up the ice, he'll send it in deep to the corner, near corner, and we've got, it looks like an icing. So that's a little confusing because Tommy Grant was definitely at the red line before he sent that in. But so the Engineers will take a defensive zone face-off here.
Yeah, see, and right now they're just showing the replay of the goal. Right on Zeke's stick off the rebound into the back of the net.
Yep. So Morello set to take the face-off on the near side in his own zone. As Drury gets tossed from the face-off circle, and he is not happy about it. Morello wins it back to Grant. Grant bounces it off the boards for Gornal, who sends it up to Bowman. Bowman sends it deep now. No icing. And the Crimson retrieve. Circling back with it is Fox. Fox sends it over. Taken by Rathbone. Rathbone sends it through, and it will be icing. So now we have another icing.
Yeah, and Harvard, a little shell-shocked, I think, right now as they just slowed the pace of this game right down. 15:55 left to play in the first. 1-0 RPI over Harvard as Chase Zeke gets a power play goal for RPI.
Yeah, they look a little just shell-shocked, like you said. Couldn't have described it better myself. Face-off taken here in the offensive zone, one back to Fox. Fox sends over to Rathbone. Rathbone tries to set it up again. Hallbauer instead bounces it off the boards and it's sent in. Polino poke checking near the Zamboni doors. He'll take it off of Rathbone's pick, but Rathbone comes away with it now. Skating up with it is Dornbach. Dornbach sends it deep and goes off for a change. Taken back now by Ferner. Ferner banks it off the bottom boards, but Harvard will continue to cycle. Ferner tries again. Now Polino with it. They get out of the zone, but Polino gets knocked off the puck, not before getting it to Lepinen. Lepinen gets a shot through that gets gloved down by Gornet, who drops it off for his defense. Now skating up with it are the Crimson. They'll send it deep. Taken behind the net now for Zetter Gossage. Gossage with it. Sends it to the point. They cycle back deep. Swings it around to the near side now. Lepinen has time, looks, decides to send it, sauce it high. Taken by Dornbach. Over to Devereaux. Devereaux sends it deep. Johnson with it now. He'll send it up for Burgess, who gets it taken off his stick. Devereaux with it again. Drops it back there for Bedini. Bedini swinging around, looking for somebody. Finds a man at the point. Stick handling, drops it back to Bedini. Bedini gets a shot through. Savory makes the initial save, and then gets it into the slot, and Burgess makes the stop. Good block there from Burgess. Savory was down. Harvard with it again. Shot sent through by Walsh. Goes high.
So 14:04 left to play in the first. 1-0 here, RPI and Harvard. And in Ithaca, it's still 1-0 RPI. 8:30 left to go in the second and that one. So we'll get out of town scores for you in a second after play is stopped here again.
Tommy Lee takes the faceoff back to Bear. Bear gets crunched off the puck. Now Tommy Grant with it. He'll bank it off the glass. Taken up by Lee. Lee plays with, sends it to Laka. Hayhurst takes it behind the net now. You can see that speed from Hayhurst that they've been missing. Grant sends it behind the net. Hayhurst with it now, circling around to the far side. He continues to circle, rips a shot. That's saved by Gournette. And Hayhurst is just a ball of energy right now. You can see him just swimming all over the ice.
Yeah, Hayhurst really, he's really excited to be on the ice after not playing for a few weeks. But we see that here. So on the men's side, some out-of-town scores for you. We have Princeton and Yale, no score. That's in New Haven. We have Dartmouth and Union, no score. That's in Schenectady. Cornell and St. Lawrence, no score. We have Colgate and Clarkson, no score. And Quinnipiac and Brown, surprise, no score. If you're an RPI fan, you are rooting for Dartmouth and Clarkson for tonight. And on the women's side, of course, it's 1-0 RPI and Cornell. And then Clarkson defeated Quinnipiac 3-0. St. Lawrence trails Princeton 2-0. And Harvard up 1-0 in Hamilton over Colgate. But here, 13:40 left to play in the first. Here it's 1-0 RPI over Harvard on Chase Zeke's power play goal. That is the 14th power play goal for RPI. They were 13.5% coming into the game. And we'll get the faceoff.
Morello takes the faceoff, sends it to the corner. Crimson retreat, that's Fladstrand with it. Sends it over to the far side where it's whipped in by Gregoire. Savory takes it back, almost turns it over, but Moore comes away with it. Whiffen now skates up over to Bowman. Bowman sends it into the slot. Morello, and the net gets knocked off its moorings, but Morello looked like he had an open net to shoot at after that initial shot from Bowman.
Yeah, well, Bowman with a nice pass, and then Morello trying to tip it in.
It looked like Fladstrand just came flying through and just knocked the net off.
Yeah, Fladstrand, actually a good defensive play, didn't mean to knock the net off. He was trying to hold up Morello, and Fladstrand went flying into the post. Yeah. So we're going to get a faceoff.
Yeah, so that was a very good setup there from Bowman. Johnson with an out. He swings around behind the net. Play sends it over to Lepinen by the Zamboni doors. Lepinen gets crunched off the puck. Now taken up by the Crimson. Skating up with his Donato. Donato over to Fladstrand. Fladstrand takes too long to get into the offensive zone, so Gregoire will get called offsides.
Yeah, and also watching the replay on that one a little bit, if Morello didn't, he had Gournette sliding. And Morello put it right into the pads. If Morello just tipped it the opposite way that Gournette was sliding, I would have been an open net. But Fladstrand got there just in time.
So engineers take the faceoff and send it deep. And it's Walsh taking it behind his own net. He gets crushed there by Moore. And Moore gets it now again by the circle. Stick handling. Decides to send it back and start the cycle. Zeke trying to come away with it. Now they send it high. That's Marino, now skating up with his Drury. Drury drops it back, but getting knocked off the puck was Bowlby by Moore. Good back check there by Moore. Burgess with it now. Engineers clear. Zeke sends it up to Burgess. Burgess can't handle, and now Drury comes back with it. Drury stick handling, gains the line. Over by the circle, he'll send it in. Grant up to Riley. Riley sends it high, banks it off the glass, where it's taken by Walsh. Walsh to Marino. Marino over to Devereaux. Walsh will send it high and into the corner. Riley comes out with it. The engineers send it back to neutral ice. A lot of tight checking going on right now. And it's Tommy Lee that's trying to break it up. Grant pinches in, keeps in the zone for the engineers. Hayhurst trying to battle what come away with it. But now skating up with it is Bachman. Bachman sends it deep. Savory decides to not stop it and leave it for Shane Bear. Shane Bear gets it up to Hayhurst. Hayhurst again with those quick feet. Sends it in. Tommy Grant will go in on the forecheck. Not something you see every day as the engineers change. Morello gets it back to the point there. Over to Whiffen, who can't keep his stick down in time for the one-timer. Now Bachman with it. Sends it up to neutral ice. Engineers look to send it right back in. They'll retreat. Taken by Hallbauer. Hallbauer stick handles, sends a guy to the ice, and that gets a whoa from the fans. Hallbauer decides to just swing it around the boards for Gornal. Held in by Ferner. Donato with it. He'll lift it high. Hallbauer punches it down and resends it in, but it's taken off, taken up by the Crimson. And they'll send it deep. Hallbauer now flicks it over to Ferner. Ferner will skate up over to Whiffen. And now Tor Linden will skate through center ice. Gains the line, but it's quickly taken off his stick. And Fox will go back the other way. Advancing are the Crimson as they send it deep with Gregoire. Ferner retreats. Engineers bank it off the glass. A lot of put back and forth play here. Not too much possession by either team. Fox now looks to start the attack. He'll skate through center ice all by himself. Gets it taken off his stick by Linden. But they Crimson keep it in. Jack Donato with it in the corner. Trying to find a point. Decides to recycle it. Gregoire. He'll send it back again. Floodstrand now. Brady Ferner just knocks him over, and we're going to have a call on that. Kind of a soft call. Looked like just kind of a check, trying to separate the man from the puck, but we're going to get cross-checking. Okay.
Yeah, cross-check, okay. 9:37 left to play in the first. 1-0 RPI over Harvard. As right now, Harvard is going to go on their first power play. It looks like RPI, as they are now going to clean off the ice. As confuses me when they open the other penalty box and they come out to clean the ice with the shovel. Because they opened the box thinking someone's going to get a call, but alas, it's just the people to clean off the ice.
No, I mean, there's definitely a cross-check in there.
Oh, yeah. No, yeah. The referee already made the call, but I thought it was going to be, you know, I thought they were going to even up for on fourth or something because they opened the other penalty box as well, but alas, it was just a crew to come out and clean the ice. So,
yeah.
So Harvard is indeed going to have a power play on this one.
Yeah, and it looks like the engineers are going to have to kill this one off here. The engineers have been pretty good on the penalty kill, 80%, as they've definitely had a stronger second half on the penalty kill. Fox with it at the point by the logo. Sent in over to Dornbach. Fox with it again at the point. Plays catch with Dornbach. Dornbach takes by the circle. Fox fakes the slap shot over to Walsh. Fox sends a shot through that's blocked by Bear. Engineers trying to get it clear. Shane Bear has it put in, has him held up in the corner. Walsh back up to Fox at the point. Flicks it over to Dornbach. They get it in low. Back up to Dornbach in the circle. Over to Fox at the point by the logo. Fox sends a shot through. That's closed off by Savory. And Tommy Grant keeps it out of the goal mouth. What a play by Tommy Grant. Savory was down. The puck flipped up through the other side. But the engineers aren't out of danger yet. Fox with it again at the point. Back to Dornbach down low. This Crimson power play just looking for an opening, looking for an opening. Fox with it again at the point. Engineers need a clear. Dornbach sends it in low, tries swinging a pass around, but it instead clears out to neutral ice. Engineers trying to get some changes out here. Sent in by Dornbach. His pass gets knocked away. Floodstrand with it now. He'll circle back over on the far side. Tommy Grant still out there for the engineers. Fox at the point. Sends it in. Bounces off the side of the cage. Floodstrand with it back up to Walsh. Over to Fox. Fox waits to Dornbach in the slot, spun around, and Whiffen will bank it off the glass and clear. 20 seconds left on the penalty kill for the Engineers. Some really good penalty killing as the Crimson were just swinging it around the umbrella at the points and just looking for an opening, but the Engineers were not willing to give him one. And when there was one there, Tommy Grant closed it up quickly. Crimson advances very quickly up the ice now as this penalty kill is about to expire, and it does. So Riley will push it back up the ice for the Engineers. Crimson unable to capitalize on that. Hayhurst comes back up with it. Now moving up with it is Bedini, as the Crimson look a little upset that they weren't able to score after having that puck in the neutral zone, or in the offensive zone, pretty much the entire power play. Moving up with this, Donato now. Over to Fledstrand, shot, bounces off of Savory's blocker.
Yeah, and on that, you mentioned the penalty kill. The penalty is killed, some great penalty killing by RPI there. Owen Savory, the defense doing a good job keeping Harvard out on the perimeter and not giving him anything. The one shot they did get, the one quality shot, Tommy Grant was right there. It almost looked like it hit him, then it hit the crossbar and went over the net.
Yeah. And he just kind of punched it into the corner to keep it out, because that goal mouth was wide open.
Yeah, 7:05 left to play in the first, 1-0 RPI.
Hallbauer with it in the far corner. Swings it back to Grant. Grant looks up ice, finds Burgess by his own bench. Burgess will decide to just send it in. Zeke goes in on the forecheck. Burgess sends a guy to the ice, but coming away with it is Rathbone. Rathbone sends it up for Fletcher, and Fletcher flies down the near wing, but Ferner able to block his pass attempt. Jack Donato with it. Sends it up to Fletcher. Over to Rathbone. Rathbone gets a shot that goes through. Push to the corner. And we've got another whistle. And so, looks like there's gonna be another Engineer going to the box. It's Burgess for hitting from behind. So that big hit, I guess, is what got him, would have gotten the penalty. Seems like they're calling a tight game here tonight. We've had three penalties already, and there's still 7 minutes left, so the Engineers have to kill off another penalty. Bear gets it back to Grant. Grant swings it around, and the Engineers get it clear. Taking it back behind his own net is Fox. Fox skates up the ice with it, drops it back for Fletstrand. Harvard gained the line. Fox over to the circle for Walsh. Fox takes back at the point, gets a shot through, and they're jamming at it, but Savory is covering.
So it's still out in Ithaca, it's still 1-0 RPI over Cornell at the end of two on a goal by Blake Juarez. One thing, checking the live stats, that stands out at me right now, the shots on goal, 33-3 in favor of Cornell, but yet RPI has the 1-0 lead. So,
and that's usually how it works with these ladies.
So Lavisa Solander standing on her head now, and 5:58 left to play in this one, 1-0 RPI.
So Dornbach loses the puck in his skates, and Whiffen takes advantage of that and sends it the length of the ice. Crimson look to gain the line again, and do. It's Walsh. He'll send it up to, but it's taken off his stick there by Riley, who actually got hooked, but no call. And he still makes it clear, 1 minute to go on this penalty kill. And Gornel now advancing in the offensive zone, continuing to pressure Dornbach. Zettergassen with it now. Zettergassen drops it back for Fox. He'll take it at the line, that's Walsh, stick handling. Sends it up to Dornbach, who misses the puck again. Back to Zettergassen. Grant chasing him. Zettergassen with it to the point. Fox with it by the logo, sends it over to Walsh. Walsh circling, gets a shot through that gets blockered aside by Savory. Engineers looking to clear, and instead it's Fox getting through to Dornbach. Dornbach circling around, gets crushed to the boards there by Gornel. Fox up to the point, slap shot, goes wide. Drury with it, over to Zettergassen. Back to Morello, and Morello will look to clear. Instead, whacks a stick out of somebody's hand as a shot goes through that gets nowhere. taken by the Engineers as they kill off the penalty. And out of the box is Payers. Payers gets a breakaway shot. Glove save by Gornett. Good heads-up play there from Hayhurst, coming right off the bench and taking the stretch pass there and just getting right into the low dot, and solid defender is coming, so he decided to take the shot, and a good save there from Gornett. That's a quality save.
Yeah, that's a quality save by Gornett and Hayhurst. Hayhurst couldn't actually, he had Fox and Shore chasing after him, so there's not much he could have done there. He opted to shoot that, and that's what he had to do. So Gornett just came up with a big save. As a nice hustle there by Fox and Shore. And on the other end, it was Jack Drury, whose stick got cleared instead of the puck.
Yeah.
As the stick went flying out. And right now, Ted Donato talking with his team.
Yeah, he's got to be a little angsty right now, as his team's had two power plays and hasn't been able to cash in on any of them. They've been swinging the puck around, getting some shots through, but Savory up to the task, and really the defense up to the task too. They've been causing havoc on these penalty kills. They've even been able to get a little bit of a forecheck going on some of them. Just active sticks and like being really active in the passing lanes. And that's what it's all about.
Yep. And right now we're gonna start again, and Ted Donato telling his team how to spin a dollar on the big wheel. I don't know if you know that reference there.
I believe I do. The Wheel of Fortune?
No, Price is Right.
Oh, okay.
Ted Donato appeared on the Price is Right back in the early 90s, I believe it was.
Oh, okay. Well before my time. So the Crimson now clear to center ice. Hallbauer retrieves. Sends it back over to his partner, Ferner. Ferner banks it off the glass, looking for Hayhurst again. Crimson return with it. Taken back by Kerfoot. Kerfoot stopped there by Hallbauer as they battle in the neutral zone. Hallbauer with it now. Sends it over to Hayhurst by his own bench. Hayhurst will come in on the near side. Sends a pot through Balaka, unable to get his stick down. And now his skate is stuck in the padding of Gornett. And he actually went flying into Gornett.
So
unable to get his stick on the puck on a great cross-ice pass there from Hayhurst.
So, yeah, the gem of Ted Donato will get a lot of Price is Right jokes in every rink that he goes to.
Tor Linden unable to win the faceoff for the Engineers. Fox takes it. Pucked off the puck was Lepinen, and a shot from Linden goes high. Good turnover from Lepinen as Fox just kind of lazily sent it back to his defenseman, and Lepinen took advantage of that.
3:27 left to play in the first, 1-0 RPI over Harvard.
Back to Johnson. Johnson over to Bowman. Bowman, shot goes high and into the netting.
So there's a picture, if you don't believe me, of a young Ted Donato with Mr. Bob Barker. So.
Linden takes the faceoff back to Bowman and kept, and unable to keep it in the zone was Bowman, but that's all good as the Engineers go back. Lepinen takes the puck back for Riley. Engineers take it back to their defensive zone. Johnson stretches it up for Lepinen. Lepinen drops it back for Laka. Laka gets a shot through that gets blocked. Crimson look to go in transition, but the Engineers back checking stops that. Now skating up with it is Bedini. Bedini will send it around. Shot blocked from Riley off of Riley's stick. Good defensive play there from Will Riley.
Yes, he also outbid a contestant by a dollar to make it up on stage. I was reading an article on theharvardcrimson.com. That's my favorite, when people outbid the people for a dollar. Especially when there's someone else left to bid and then that person outbids them by the dollar. Love it.
As back to action here at the Fieldhouse. I'm Joseph Pisacano with Ed DeGuerin. You're listening to live coverage of RPI Hockey on 91.5 WRPI Troy. Crimson starting to put some pressure here as they've been cycling in the offensive zone. With Drury with it, he'll continue to swing around as the Engineers look to clear. Burgess getting pushed around, but the Engineers do clear down to neutral ice. Icing gets waved off as Walsh will send it back. Now moving up with his Marino. Marino sends it in for Drury. Drury drops it back, but it's checked off the puck by Whiffen. Now Moore with it. Moore looking for Burgess, but instead skates in himself. Drops it back for Riley. Riley finds an opening. Glove save by Gournette. Oh, what a save from Gournette as Riley had the slot wide open and certainly took advantage of it. I mean, the Engineers are getting opportunities, and they are getting really close to capitalizing on them if it weren't for a great goal.
1:51 left to play in the first. If you're wondering, this is my last comment on it. Ted Donato, he lost a car playing the dice game. We have to guess if it's higher or lower than the number, and he lost a car. Apparently he rolled a 2, and it was a 1. So he missed it.
Oh, well. Poor Ted. So
he can afford one now, though. So
so now taken up by the Crimson, who get a shot through from Rathbone. That Savory covers up.
So here, 1:34 left to play in the first, 1-0 RPI over Harvard on Chase Seeky's power play goal. RPI playing really, really well. And shots right now 13-11 in favor of Harvard. So that evened out remarkably.
Harvard continues to put the pressure on here. Getting knocked off the puck. It's Rathbone. Now it's pushed ahead by Riley. Tries to find Whiffen. Sends it back to Johnson. Johnson now stretches it up for Gorner. Gorner slips a little bit. Gets his footing back. Gets a shot through. That's covered by Gournette. Another glove save from Gournette. Engineers are starting to get some pressure. They're starting to put some shots on. Shots at 12 for the Engineers and 13 for the Crimson right now. So a pretty even game in terms of that category. Certainly not like the women's game, who they're getting outshot 33-3. But up 1-0, and that's where it matters.
Yep.
Tommy Lee set to take the faceoff on this all-freshman line. Lee gets it up, but it's taken back by the Crimson. Fletcher moving with it now. Coming through is Bedini, whose shot gets cut, blocked aside by Savory. That was a really good save there from Savory as Bedini found some open ice. Hayhurst with it now. He'll send it around, taken by Lee. Lee gets it taken off his stick and moving up with it is Fletstrand. Fletstrand over to Hallbauer. Hallbauer takes it away. Now skating up with his Ferner to Laca. Laca gets it taken off his stick, moving up with his Marino. Marino takes it in himself, gets taken off the puck, but they still got a shot off. Crimson with it still. They'll cycle. Gregoire with it, gets a shot through, that's blocked aside by the Engineer defense. Hallbauer will skate up with it. Laca gets knocked down in open ice, but not before sending the puck deep. Crimson send it all the way down the ice, but that will be an icing.
So 1.9 seconds remaining in this one, in the first period, 1-0 RPI and Harvard. Pretty much we're gonna get a face-off in the Harvard zone, and that will pretty much do it for this period.
So yeah, the Engineers should be up, barring any unforeseen circumstances, 1-0 at the end of this period. Lepinen set to take the faceoff. And it is won by the Crimson. And that is how this period will end. So the Engineers up 1-0 over the Harvard Crimson. Shots 12 for the Engineers, 15 for the Crimson. And the Engineers have 10 faceoff wins to the Crimson 14. And the Engineers are really there. It's a pretty even game so far, but they were on the... It wasn't even really a lucky bounce. It was a good play by the Engineers on the power play as Zeke gets his 8th goal of the season.
Yeah, no, it was a really good play as they had Laca and Zeke posted up on either side of the crease waiting for Gournette to kick the rebounds out, because he has been doing that all game. And at that time, he just kicked the rebound out right to Zeke's stick, and Zeke put it in the back of the net, and that's where we stand. RPI 1-for-1 on the power play, Harvard 0-for-2, and RPI has the 1-0 lead. So it was a really good all-around period. And on the penalty kill, RPI playing really well on the penalty kill as well. Tommy Grant coming up huge, keep the puck out of the net on a stop by Owen Savory.
And you hope that in a game like this, the Engineers don't lull themselves asleep, because they got keep bringing this energy, because they are playing well, but they can't think that they're just going to play well all the time. They need to make sure that they're active and that they keep their energy up.
And that will do it here for the first period of play. We'll be back here for a intermission shortly. The score here after one period of play is RPI 1, Harvard 0. You're listening to live coverage of Engineer Hockey on 91.5 FM, WRPI, Troy.
Right now.
Western Polytechnic Institute in Troy, New York, for the second period of play, between RPI and Harvard. RPI currently has a 1-0 lead at the gear, along with Joe Piscano here on the call for you on 91.5 FM WRPI Troy. Before we get started with the second period of play, we'd like to thank the Wrestling Union for funding for WRPI and all club-related activity of the Institute, including WRPI's coverage of RPI men's and women's ice hockey, football, and baseball later on in the season. We'd also like to thank you for listening on the World Wide Web. Point your browser to www.wrpi.org. And you can hear our broadcast 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. So long as WRPI is broadcasting, we will provide that broadcast on the internet feed. Once again, that is www.wrpi.org. We'd also like to remind you that out in Ithaca, it's RPI and Cornell tied at one right now as the fire alarm just went off in the Houston Fieldhouse. So we are not sure what's going on. Nobody seems to be leaving. Anyway, it's 1-1 out in Ithaca, women Ithaca. So it wasn't any of us that tripped the fire alarm, but the fire alarm is going off. Fans are getting up, starting to leave. So apparently
I believe
we have to leave the arena.
And we'll be back.
We will be back. We are going to flip it right over to this. Once again, you are listening to 91.5 FM WRPI Troy. The studio back at the DCC will be taking over, and we'll be back here for you as we are currently had a fire alarm go off in the building. We will be back. Thank you. here to the Houston Fieldhouse on the campus of Rensselaer Polytechnic Institute in Truro, New York. The building is still standing. We are back in the building. Edgar Garrett and Joe Pisacano here on 91.5 FM WRPI Truro. Score after one period of play is RPI 1, Harvard 0. You're listening to live coverage of the game on 91.5 FM WRPI Troy. And before we left you, we were about ready to go back on the air, and the fire alarm went off just as the puck was dropping for the second period. So the teams will be given a brief warm-up period before restarting the game. So luckily it went off. There was nothing going on. Teams were already coming back off the break, so there was no break in momentum or anything like that. So that's what happened, and the word on the street is that it was a popcorn machine was burning.
Sudden death overtime. That's where Blake Oros excels.
I don't know if it's sudden death anymore. I think they changed it to sudden victory. I think someone complained that sudden death was a little too violent.
Well, golden goal. We'll call it a golden goal. Golden goal. I remember that term from soccer.
But either way, you're correct. Next goal wins out at Ithaca.
Yes, next goal wins out at Ithaca. And the Engineers, they fought hard in this game. Again, getting completely outshot. In the shots category, Cornell has taken 98 shots. They've missed almost half of them, but they've gotten 48 on net to the Engineers' 5. So the Engineers are going to have to put at least one more on net if they want to win this one. But they'll play until the end. So now
teams are about ready to go here. Never in my life has that happened to me. I've been a fan of RPI hockey since the year after they won the national championship in 1986. Coming to game ball that time, never has that happened to me before.
So Engineers win the faceoff, brought back to Riley. Riley sends it over to Johnson. Johnson sends it deep and high into the corner. It's taken now by the Crimson, skating up with it. Riley takes it off their stick. Gets it right back up to Lepinen, over to Linden. Linden gets a shot that dwindles through, pushed aside by Gournette. Taken now by the Crimson. Moving up with it is Kerfoot. Kerfoot drops it back. Sent through, goes wide. Polino skates up with it. Looking for a pass, finds one to Bear. Bear goes behind the net, centers it, taken by Grant. Shot gets pushed aside. Good shot there from Grant on the trail. Bear skates it up for Gornell. Harvard recovers now. Getting pushed off the puck by Gornell. They'll send it deep. Taken by Morello. Poked off of his stick. Harvard trying to cycle. Gornell having none of it, pushes it to neutral ice. Walsh with it. Whiffen dumps him to the ice. That's Dornbach. Dornbach trying to kick the puck into the zone, gets knocked over by Grant. And now the Engineers will recover. Shane Bear with it. Takes it behind his own net. Banks it off the glass. Taken now by Morello. Morello circles in. Fans on the pass, but gets it deep. Crimson quickly recovered to neutral ice. They'll send it deep. Now taken there by Devereaux. Devereaux trying to center. Taken off his stick. Moore with it. Sends it behind for Hallbauer. Hallbauer banks it off the boards for Burgess. Ferner sends a guy to the ice. Coming in with his Bobini. Bobini stops on a dive but doesn't fool Moore. Moore stays right with him. Hallbauer sends it to the point. Shot gets through, trickles through. Savory took a deflection but it went wide. Now by Bobini again. Takes in at the point. Shot goes through, glove, but pushed down. Zeke trying to clear, cannot. Moore with it behind the net. He'll whip it around. Zeke takes by the penalty doors. but quickly recovered by the Crimson. Engineers look to be struggling a little bit here. Ferner holds the passing lane. Hallbauer banks it off the glass and clears the length of the ice, so we're going to get an icing here.
So now that we'll set up 17-13 left to play in the second, 1-0 RPI over Harvard. And we are back from the fire alarm. So I've been on the air, you know, since I started doing this, I've never had the fire alarm go off. I was on the air for the infamous t-shirt in the Zamboni at Union. That was a fun one. When the Zamboni broke down, and then one Zamboni was about a 40-minute delay to get a new Zamboni. So 17-13 left to play in the second, 1-0 RPI. At least this time we got to go outside and got fresh air.
Yes, agreed. Crimson win the faceoff back. They've really been pressuring these last couple minutes. And as the shot goes through, it's in the slot area. Engineers able to pull it out after the initial save. The Crimson keep it right in the offensive zone. They take it over by the near boards now. Taken up to the point for Fox. Fox walks the line. Back over. Shot comes through. Savory can't see it. Hallbauer gets tripped up trying to clear, and no call there.
It looks like we're going to get a, it looked like it went into the Harvard bench. So that's what the whistle was for.
I'm confused how there was no tripping call there as Hallbauer was attempting to make the clear and there was a stick right on top of him and tripped over it. But as it is, neutral ice faceoff coming up for Tommy Lee. Tommy Lee sends it back for Bear. Bear tries to send it up, but it skates through. But Hayhurst will beat the icing. Good play there from Hayhurst. Holds it to the point, whips it back around. Stopped by Gournette. Now Harvard skates up with it. Coming down the far side is Floodstrand. Floodstrand gets taken off his stick. Engineers clear. Fox sends it all the way, but it was tipped, so no icing. Riley sends it up the boards. Engineers battle and clear. Now Walsh with it. Walsh over to Marino. Marino on the far side. Just tries to send it through, gets a deflection. Riley will recover. Riley now looking for a man. Banks it off the boards for Lepinen, who gets a stick on it. Both teams just kind of sending the puck back and forth down the ice as we get an icing.
So 15:43 left to play in the second, 1-0 RPI in Harvard. We're just returning, if you're just tuning in, we are returning from a fire alarm we had earlier before the second period even began. So that's why the second period is off to a late start. 15:43 left to play in the second, 1-0 RPI over Harvard. Shot 17-13 in favor of the Crimson.
Bear sends it in. Crimson come out with it. Now taken by the Crimson as they push it in towards the net. Savory inside his own net, somehow keeps it out. Polino now skates across the crest. Drops it back, but unable to get it was Grant. Savory takes it behind the net. For Bear. Bear drops it back to Grant. Crimson have it in the neutral zone. Gregoire taps it there for Floodstrand. Floodstrand skating, sends a shot through, hits the pipe. That one got past Savory. Luckily he had a pipe. Morello trying to clear now, angles his body and does. Crimson really, really swarming right now. Shane Bear trying to push his man off the puck. Whiffen with it. Whiffen sends it down. Taken by the Crimson. Sent into the boards was Donato by Brady Whiffen. And that was a legal check, might add. Ferner. Ferner sends it up for Gornal. Gornal sends it deep on the far side. Engineers are skating from left to right on your radio dial. Gornal with it behind the net. Trying to dig it out of some skates. Engineers just trying to create some pressure as it's been all Harvard real these last few minutes. Gornal with it behind his own net. Gornal sends it to Ferner. Ferner pinching in, held in by Lee. Lee fakes the slap shot, decides to send it back around for Hayhurst. Hayhurst has some speed. Sends up to Hallbauer at the point. Hallbauer sends a shot that goes off a shin pad. They'll go back to the corner. Hayhurst has it on the half board, sends it back to the point for Hallbauer. Hallbauer fakes the pass, goes in. Shot goes through, almost into the net. Harvard recovers and clears all the way down the ice, but we'll get an icing.
RPI again, almost having to put one in, almost putting one in. Gornet flopping around on the ice, making the save, and keeping RPI having one on the scoreboard. 13-10 left to play in the second. 1-0 RPI over Harvard. Shots 18-14 now in favor of the Crimson.
Yeah, those good chances seem to come when they get a deflection or a rebound. So I've got to keep doing that for the Engineers. Moore with it. Moore gets it to Zeke. Zeke's shot goes wide. Johnson tries to hold it in along the half boards. Held in there by Moore, but Moore will skate it back in after his team comes onside. Drops it back for Riley. Riley misses it. Harvard tries to counter, but unable to do so, so the Engineers do as well. Moore takes a shot from the circle, and it's gloved down by Gornet.
Yep, Gornet with a save on Mirth Moore. As now the teams are going to the bench for a media timeout. 12:47 left to play in the first, 1-0 RPI. We will give you some out-of-town scores. On the women's side, Clarkson defeated Quinnipiac 3-0. RPI and Cornell head into overtime at 1. Princeton leads St. Lawrence by a score of 4-1. And Harvard over Colgate 5-2 in Hamilton. And then on the men's side, we'll wait for my computer to refresh here. We have, obviously, he's 1-0 RPI over Harvard. We have Princeton and Yale tied at 1. That's late in the second. Then Union and Dartmouth still scoreless late in the second. Cornell over St. Lawrence 3-1 up in Canton. And then Colgate 1-0 over Clarkson up in Potsdam. That's the end of 2. That's not good news for the if you're an Engineer fan. And then Quinnipiac all over Brown 3-0. So the Engineers rooting for Clarkson and Dartmouth in the two games of interest to RPI.
Johnson unable to hold it in at the point. He'll skate back to his own zone, whips it up to Lepinen. And we got a whistle, maybe an offsides.
Yes, indeed it was offsides. 12:31 left to play in the second. And RPI and Harvard here. So for RPI, they need a sweep on the weekend. If the score holds up, that is a good sign for them.
Donato with, excuse me, if that's Fox with it, unable to get his man Rathbone, so they'll have to skate back to their own zone. Fox with it, over to Rathbone. Sends it up to Riley. Now taken by Drury. Drury skates in, sends it over, but unable to get the shot off was Bowlby. Harvard continuing to press. Engineers trying to clear. Linden banks it up over the glass.
11:59 left to play in second. I think regardless of what happens, regardless of where RPI finishes in the standings, whether it be 8th, 9th, 10th, they will be a tough out in the playoffs. The way they've been playing, especially over the last couple of months here. So, and they definitely are a different team than they were in the first half of this season. So RPI probably will be a tough out no matter who they play. But as you mentioned, you know, they probably want to get as close to home as possible, which would be Union if they go on the road.
Face-off taken here. Fletcher and battling. Excuse me, it's Zetter Gossage. Shane Baer sends it behind his own net, getting whacked there by Zetter Gossage. Tommy Grant now gets knocked off puck, but not before getting it to Gornal. Now skating up with it is Shane Bear. Shane Bear trying to get a rush going here. Hayhurst looking around behind the net. Nothing. Morello sends it back. Excuse me, that's Shane Bear sending it deep. Harvard recovers. They send it deep. Ferner takes it behind his own net. Drop back for Bear. Bear sends it up for Gornal. Gornal sends it through. Taken by the Crimson. That's Marino skating up with it. Now Bandini. Bandini gets knocked off the puck by Whiffen. Harvard held in at the point. Bandini with again. He gets knocked off the puck by Whiffen. Whiffen whacking really hard with that stick. Now Tommy Lee. He'll skate it up their neutral ice and send it deep. Crimson continuing to push. Bowman backchecking hard. Donato gets it taken off the stick by Hayhurst. Sends it deep. Pushed aside by Gournette. Now sent through. Hayhurst has it in the neutral zone. Harvard continuing to press a lot here. Hayhurst trying to clear. Johnson over to Riley. Riley centers it there for Hayhurst. Hayhurst skates through neutral ice. Gains the line. Gets whacked off the puck. Hayhurst, excuse me, that's Harvard coming back. Moore with it now. Moore skates up with Burgess. Moore down the near side. Centers it. Puck gets pushed off. Crimson send it high. Sent in deep there by Gregoire. Engineers attempting to clear. Gregoire knocks Zeke off the puck. Knocked right back down by the Crimson. Gregoire with it. Taken off of his stick by Burgess. Burgess to Moore. Moore gains the line. Sends it in. Burgess comes from behind the net to get it, but no luck. Now skating up with it. Crimson gets a shot through. That gets by Savory, but again, bounces off and into the corner. Burgess, good attack there at the point. Taken now by the Crimson. They'll send it in. Shot gets through. Savory makes the initial save, but the rebound comes out. And Casey Dornbach ties this one up. 8:34 to go in the second.
And what happened on that goal was actually the official started that as it was being, it was attempted to be cleared out by an RPI player, and it hit the official in the leg, hit the linesman in the leg and bounced right to Harvard out in front, and Savory makes the initial stop. Savory makes the initial great stop, and then he was definitely out of position for the rebound, and then John Marino
Misses it, really.
Yep. Savory just missed it when he dived back, but John Marino getting the goal. So, bit of unfortunate luck there for the engineers as the linesman getting the puck, but the linesman is a part of the ice and is part of the play, and if it bounces off the linesman, then there's nothing really you can do about it. 8:34 left to play in the second, 1-1 RPI at Harvard.
So Harvard, all that pushing eventually results in a goal as we are tied at one here. And an icing now as the engineers will find themselves again in the defensive zone. Crimson win the faceoff back, but they have to go back to their own zone. Walsh over to Fox. Crimson move back up. Engineers trying to get this one back. A little bit of a lull from them here in this period. Maybe the fire alarm threw them off a little. Now Bandini with it again. Drops it back. Shot gets through. Does not get through Savory, though. Engineers look to clear. Savory somehow able to clear that net. Excuse me, cover that net. Morris sends it up for Morella. Over to Whiffen. Whiffen in the corner. Taken by Morello. Now Crimson push back up with it. Bear takes it in his own corner. Leaves it for Grant. Grant tries the outlet. Can't get it to Morello. Crimson continue to push. That's Zerder Gossage. At the point, shot goes through, bounces behind the net. Now shot comes through from Rathbone, and he hits near corner, top shelf, right in.
So just like that, Harvard keeping up the pressure, and Rathbone puts it in the back of the net behind Savory. So a pair of defensive breakdowns for RPI. Well, the first one wasn't really a defensive breakdown, just a bit of unfortunate luck, but that goal by Rathbone, a defensive breakdown for the Engineers.
Yeah, if I'm Coach Smith, I'm calling timeout right now, and I'm getting the guys back here, because this does not look like the team that we saw in the first period.
Yeah, there was three Engineers on the Harvard forward and nobody on Rathbone, and Rathbone just snuck in the back and put it in the back of the net.
Crimson pushed back up with Zitter Gossage. He'll skate up with it. Excuse me, that's Gregoire. Gregoire again gains the line, comes through, but it's poked away by Hallbauer. Hayhurst looks back up to push up the ice. He'll skate through with it. Drop back for Tommy Lee. Now taken by Fox. Fox dangles by Laka. Drops it back, but it's taken by Hayhurst. Hayhurst intercepts. Sent high for Laka, but no luck. Johnson gets a stick on a stretch pass and retrieves it behind his own net. Up to Laka now on the half boards. Passes gets intercepted. Bowlby with it now. Bowlby centers. Shot gets blocked from Drury. Now coming away with it is Dornbach. Dornbach, the first goal scorer for the Crimson. Drury with it. Drury sends it back to Dornbach. Dornbach's shot gets blocked by an Engineer stick. Bowman finds Moore. Moore slaps the puck into the offensive zone. Crimson quickly recover. Moving up with it is Bachman. Bachman sends it deep before taking a hit. Engineers battle for it by the Zamboni doors. Ferner comes away with it. Now Zeke. Zeke sends it in. Crimson having man open as the Engineers were caught changing, but Riley catches up to him. Still with it is Devereaux. Devereaux shoved out the puck. Now Bandini with it. Bandini has been all over the ice in this period. Every Engineer that's been guarding him seems to have been just chasing. Walsh gets a shot that Savory covers.
5 minutes left to play in the second. 2-1 Harvard over RPI. And in women's hockey, it's still 1-1, RPI and Cornell. Shots, total shots right now, actually 108-11 on goal. It's 52-5. So a lot of block shots for the Engineers, and a lot of shots on goal for the Big Red in Ithaca. But it's still hold tight, 1-1. Lovisa Solander doing an excellent job. We don't have the feeds up, but just from the stats of the game, we can tell Lovisa Solander is doing an excellent job. Here is 2-1 Harvard over RPI, and
two quick goals
for Harvard, for Crimson. And Union leads Dartmouth 1-0, and Colgate still leads Clarkson 1-0. So of the three games, the Engineers need to go their way, none of them are, including their own. So, well, the three including theirs in the three, none of them are going their way, just to clarify that. So 5 minutes left to play in the second, 2-1 Harvard over RPI.
Yeah, so they need to pick up their energy here for sure. It's looking a little lackadaisical in this second period are the Engineers. 5 minutes to go in the second. Jake Johnson with it now. Sends it through to neutral ice. Pass gets intercepted. Zerder Gossage finds Kerfoot. Kerfoot sends a shot through that Saver easily covers.
Yeah, and like you said, they are looking a little lackadaisical down there. Totally different team than what happened in the first half. You know, and who knows if there wasn't a fire alarm, maybe they would have came off the jump, but maybe the fire alarm did take a little bit of their excitement out of coming back in. But 4:45 left to play in the second, 2-1 Harvard.
Another shot goes wide as Lepinen looks to break out. He gets banks it all high off the ports, and it gets to neutral ice. Riley with it over to Johnson. Johnson sends it up for Linden. Linden back to Polino, who starts the cycle. Sergio Gossage takes the bouncing puck. Sends it to Bandini, who drops it back for him. Shot goes through, bounces off an Engineer. Grant shoves his man to try and separate the puck, and does. Tor Linden trying to come out with it. Takes it up along the half boards and bounces it high. Gornal beats out the icing, but Crimson come away with it. Now skating up with this Marino. Marino gets a shot through, covered by Savory.
3:41 left to play in the second. Savory with another save, keeping this game 2-1. Nice hustle by Mike Gornal, beating out the icing call. So shot 25-18 in favor of Harvard. Harvard scoring two quick goals to take a 2-1 lead here in this one. Yeah. And Troy.
Engineers only have 4 shots on net in this period. The Crimson have 10, so certainly carrying the play. And they haven't had any power plays, so that certainly hasn't been a reason why. And we've got a stoppage here. Engineers look to regroup.
Going to the bench. 3:41 left to play in the second. 2-1 RPI over Harvard. RPI had a 1-0 lead going into the first intermission. Teams came back out of the ice. The puck was about to drop. The referee just had the puck in his hand holding over the circle. And the fire alarm goes off, so everybody has to evacuate the building. They're out there for about 10 minutes or so. And we got to go ahead to go back in. And the puck dropped. It was all Harvard. So after the fire alarm, Harvard really took this game over, scored 2 quick goals. One was unfortunate for RPI, bouncing off the lineman's leg. And the second one was a defensive breakdown for RPI, as Rathbone had a clear look at Savory and just beat Savory. So that's where we stand.
Indeed. Face off taken here, won by Hayhurst. Hayhurst gets around to check. Tommy Lee trying to keep the puck in the engineer zone, but to no luck. Coming back with it is Rathbone. Rathbone, the late goal scorer. Engineers battle for it in the near corner. Laka, this freshman out of Bratislava, Slovakia. Now taken again, wraparound attempt. Pushed away by Hayhurst. Good poke check there. Knocks away the wraparound attempt. Hayhurst sends it back to Ferner. Ferner skates. Ferner with some speed gets his stick tied up, banks it off into neutral ice. And Tommy Lee almost had a bit of a breakaway there, but unable to capitalize. Crimson push back. They send a puck through, bounces off of Savory's blocker and into the corner. Crimson take it behind their own net. 2:20 to go here in the second period. Engineers down 2-1 after scoring first. Have really not played that great in this second period. Crimson come back with it. They send it deep. Tommy Grant trying to clear. Centered there, but Bowman comes away with it. Bowman skates up. Banks it off the boards. Sends it deep. Almost stolen away there by Whippen, and a shot comes through. Good opportunity there from Gornal, but no luck on there. Johnson sends it to Riley. Riley circles back. Sends it to Polino. Polino gains the line. Gets knocked down. Behind the net is Marino. Crimson start up. Moving up with it is Bandini. Bandini gets a shot. Savory saves it. Now to Zeke. Zeke gets it to neutral ice. Bandini takes it back. Crimson skating through center ice. Fox tries to get through, does. Plays give and go. Crimson have it behind the net. Savory looking around, trying to find the puck. Sent back. Johnson battles for it near the Zamboni doors with Tor Linden. Will Riley heads up the ice, finds Polino. Polino has it bounce off the stick. Crimson come back. Polino almost runs into Riley. Instead, finds Polino, who sends it deep. Crimson trying to counter. Ferner takes it behind his own net. Sends it up there for Hayhurst, who drops it in. Stopped there by Gornet. Tommy Grant with it now. Circles back. Engineers trying to gain some sort of possession here as the period ends.
And that was not a good period for RPI at all.
No, it just came out really flat and never really covered. I'm trying to think of one really good chance at that. I think they had maybe one good scoring chance.
Yeah, came out flat, never recovered. Your coach, Dave Smith, you got to go and talk to the team and say, hey guys, you can't come out like that, like what happened, especially with a good team like Harvard.
So they find themselves down yet again.
Yeah, I mean, Gornet had four saves in that second period. Not a lot, four shots on goal for the Engineers in that period. So your coach, Dave Smith, you have to go and talk to him. I talked to your team about not coming out flat. Of course, I'm sure the fire alarm and the fire drill.
Yeah, but it affects both teams.
It does affect both teams, yes.
Especially since the Crimson had to go back on a bus, and RPI, the Engineers, got to go up and hang out at the East Campus of Athletic Village. But Crimson take a 2-1 lead here into the third period.
Yeah, so we'll be back in a couple of minutes here to bring you the second intermission. Score here after two periods of play is Harvard 2, RPI 1. You're listening to live coverage of RPI Hockey on 91.5 FM, WRPI, Troy.
Stephanie Warner.
Houston Fieldhouse on the campus of Rensselaer Hall set to get the 2-game score in New York for the third period of tonight's game between the RPI Engineers and the Harvard Crimson. Score here after two periods of play as Harvard 2, RPI 1. But the game jump is kind of here on the call for you on 91.5 FM WRPI Troy. Before we get started with the third period of play, we'd like to thank the Rensselaer Union for providing funding for WRPI all club-related activity of the Institute, including WRPI's coverage of men's and women's ice hockey, football, and baseball later on in the season. Also, I recommend you, if you are not near a radio, but you can get near a computer, you can listen to our broadcast on our internet feed, www.wrpi.org. Once again, it is www.wrpi.org. As long as we are broadcasting, we will provide broadcast on the internet feed.
Faceoff. Linden takes the faceoff back for the Engineers as that Polino whiffs on the dump-in attempt, but gets it back on the second chance. Polino keeps it in the zone at the point. Harvard tries to push back and does. Fox with it. Fox stick handles by Lepinen. Shore sends it in. Savory stops behind his net. Sends it to Grant. Grant bounces it up. Finds Lepinen. Lepinen now skate down the far side. Pushes it in. Marino takes the puck off the stick. Shore comes down the near side now. Tries to pass it, but it bounces off of Lepinen's stick and goes high. Crimson trying to get a bit of that swarm that they had in the first period. With behind the net is Bowlby. Bowlby circles around, gets pushed down. Coming away with it is Drury. Morello now trying to push back, and does. Finds Whiffen. Whiffen gets tripped up. Gets it back to Bear. Bear now skates through neutral ice. Tips it off a Whiffen stick, and Whiffen will chase. Whiffen trying to could get a forecheck on for the Engineers. Pushed back by Devereaux. Devereaux sends it deep, but Ferner will quickly recover. Circles around, gains some speed. Leaves it behind the net for Laka. Laka by the half boards. Sends it high. And it goes the length of the ice, and Hayhurst will not beat the icing this time, but he came pretty dang close.
Yes, you are listening to WRPI Troy, 91.5 FM at the Gary and Joe Piscana here on the call for you. Score here currently as Harvard 2, RPI 1. We also failed to make an announcement that if you're a current RPI student and you want to make live calls of the game, such as the one you're listening to today, shoot us an email at wrpi-sports@rpi.edu. We'll do our best to accommodate you.
Crimson win the faceoff. Sends it behind the net. Taken there by Bedini. Bedini shoves off Tommy Lee. Continues to get pushed towards the net. Gets a shot off that gets pushed aside by Savory. Pushed back in by Bachman. Bachman to Devereaux. Devereaux behind it has the puck jammed against the glass. Engineers come out with it. Skating up with it now is Laka. Laka sends it over for Hayers. Hayers gains line, takes it back, tries to get a pass through, almost does, but Tommy Lee finds himself face to face with Gournett. And yeah, we have a stoppage.
Yeah, Tommy Lee was probably anticipating a pass there for to Gournett. And he just gets taken down into Gournett. So that draws a whistle. So like we said, if you're a current student, you want to make live calls of the game, you're going to shoot us an email at wrpi-sports@rpi.edu. That's Joe. That's how you came to us. And Joe is now doing fantastic. So if you want to try your hand, just shoot us an email.
Shane Bear sends it over to Tommy Grant. Grant bounces it off a Bert Zeke's stick. Moore hacking, trying to find the puck. Goes back to Grant. Grant skates with it along his own bench. He'll send it deep. Engineers trying to gain some form of possession here, but Crimson quickly coming back with it now. Gregoire whips it around, centers it, shot faked, goes up into Savory. Rathbone with that strong shot there. Fox gets a shot that bounces off of Burgess's stick. Crimson starting to swarm a little. Zeke intercepts the pass, sauces it up to Mears Moore. Moore unfortunately goes offsides.
Yeah, Moore just got tied up with Fox there.
Yeah,
he let a drop pass back, but he just gets tied up with Fox. Just forgot to clear the zone. That's a good bad.
Yeah. So. 16:54 to go in the third period. Engineers down 2-1. Will Riley sends it deep. Engineers look to gain some possession now in the offensive zone in the near corner. Leppinen with it. He'll cycle. Sends it back to Linden. Linden dangles. Gets it up to the point for Johnson. Johnson gets a shot through. That gets blocked, but there's gets shoveled in there from Leppinen. Pushed aside by Gornett. Crimson move up. Johnson, active stick there, gets it to Bowman. Now skating up with it are the Crimson. They get a shot through, that's Walsh, but it goes behind the net. Shot went wide. Taken back now by Kerfoot. Kerfoot tries to spin around it. Will Riley has none of it. Now up to Flutz. Strand, but it gets pushed off of him. Kerfoot with it in the corner again. Up to the point. Shot goes through for Walsh, but it goes wide. Will Riley circling around. Continues to circle behind his net. Crimson go off on a change. Sends it to Johnson on the near side. Johnson will skate up. Sends it back to Riley towards the center. They play catch. Johnson sends it to Gornell, who goes deep with it. Morello knifes it off of the stick of Millar. Now Bachman has it. Engineers and the Crimson continue to just look for one team to make a mistake, it seems. Bounces off of Gornell's stick. Scooby does not. And they're going to call an icing here, but Whiffen was clearly ahead of Bachman.
Yeah, fans not happy with that ball, but not really getting much of a protest from Coach Smith either, so, you know, not worth arguing. 15-12 left to play in the third. The Crimson continue to lead this one, 2-1.
Yeah, and no team has gotten a shot off in the first 5 minutes, so really just not much. No team has got a shot on goal. They've gotten shots off, but they've all been blocked before they made it through. Morello puts a guy to the ice in the corner.
Delayed penalty. Yep. And delayed penalty against RPI. So 14:55 left to play in the third. Shots 25-17 in favor of the Crimson. So,
and this is not a way to spark yourself. And they've been calling it tight, like a tight game all night. And Morello goes to the box for boarding, which, I mean, I certainly haven't seen them make calls like this all season. But they're calling them tonight. So you got to do what the officials say.
Yep.
So Linden takes the faceoff as the Engineers look to kill off this penalty and maybe get some energy from it. Linden skates up. Finds Polino as they look. Polino looks to skate. Circles around by the circle, gets a shot through. There was an opening, but Linden unable to get the rebound. Engineers send it back and look to kill more time. Back to Polino. Polino banks it off for Ferner. Over to Grant. Grant sends it the length of the ice, where it's blocked aside by Gornett. Whiffen has it now by the Zamboni doors. And it's taken off of his stick. So the Engineers kill a solid 40 seconds of that penalty. Fox with it now. He'll look to set up. Sends it through the legs of Hayhurst for Dornbach. Dornbach circles around behind the net. Crimson set up. They get to Fox at the point. Fox back to Walsh. Walsh circles. Over to Fox. They play catch with Dornbach. Back to Fox and Walsh. They'll continue to circle around at the top of this umbrella. Walsh with it again at the dot. Sends it in towards the slot area. Taking off of Zettergosh's stick. Dornbach with it again. He's already got one tonight. Gets it back to Fox at the circle. Over to Walsh by the logo. Slap shot comes through, saved by Savory. Rebound, Savory covers it up.
13:25 left to play in the third. Harvard leads RPI 2-1. Morello in the penalty box for another 30 seconds. As after Morello comes out, RPI looking to tie this one up. If you're an Engineer fan, you need them to tie this one up. as in order to have a shot at home ice in the playoffs. RPI needs to win this game. They can't tie, they can't lose, they must win. 13-25, let's play the third, 2-1 Harvard.
Riley swings it back and out of the zone. 25 seconds to go on the penalty. Engineers continuing to be aggressive here on this penalty kill with Polino and Linden. Johnson with it behind the net. 6 seconds left. Sent back over to Marino. Marino over to Rathbone. Rathbone gets a shot through, goes wide. Harvard continues to press though, despite the penalty being killed. Held in by Rathbone. He sends a shot through that Savory pushes aside. Engineers now look to break out. Here comes Burgess. He'll bank it off the glass and retrieve it himself. Big hit there from Moore in the corner. Crimson circle back. Moore puts another body on shore. Taken back by Rathbone. Rathbone puts it up for Donato. Donato sends it in to the near corner. Ferner retrieves. Ison gets waved off. Now coming up with it is Bachman. Bachman pushes it up. Hayhurst with it now. Hayhurst has it in his own zone. He circles back, tries to gain some speed, surveys the ice, drops it back. Now taken by Hallbauer. Whole circle back and survey. Over to Bowman. Bowman plays with Moore. Moore gets a shot through that bounces off the knee of Hayhurst. Hayhurst trying to spark plug. Shane Bear will send it in. Moore takes by the Zamboni doors. Up to the point for Grant. Now they crush it along the half boards to Grant and Moore. Taken back by Fletcher. He'll knife it through. Now with it is Bowlby. He'll get knocked down. Bowlby has it along the half boards. Crimson come back. Here comes Bowlby. Bowlby has it in the near corner. He gets pushed off the puck by Riley. And Crimson quickly recovers to Fox, who dumps in from the red line. Bounces off of the ref. Johnson has it behind. Tries to clear the point. Fox there to stop it. He'll send it deep. Bowlby with it. Bowlby circles. And now we've got a penalty called. And Jack Drury is not happy about that at all.
Nope, it's interference. Jack Drury is not Harvard, is not happy that the penalty was on Harvard, is what I meant to say. So out of town scores for you, Union and Dartmouth. Union is up 2-1 late in the third. And Clarkson and Colgate, Clarkson is up 3-2 late in the third. So RPI, this is their chance to get the tying goal back and see what happens. But right now they...
And they scored, they scored on their last power play. So this is what could spark plug this team, as they already have had Zeke put one in on the power play and they haven't had one since. So there's certainly reason to believe that they could score again, because as you said, they looked really good on that first power play.
Yeah, they did. And hopefully for the engineers, and Dave Smith comes back with the same setup with Laka and Zeke right on the goal lines. And I didn't see who it was in the center.
Well, we've got Leppinen here. Leppinen here for the engineers now. Laka to take the face off. And then you got Riley and Bear as defensemen on this unit. But the Crimson come out and win the face off. But they try to clear, can't, and then do. So not a great start. But Savory stops behind the net as the engineers look to set up. Bear comes up with it, passes it to Leppinen. Leppinen decides to just whip it in. Gournette unable to stop it. Leppinen takes it, Riley has it now. He'll cycle back. Leppinen with it. Sends a shot through, but it goes nowhere. Leppinen with it. He'll swing it around behind the net for Riley. Riley skates back up with the puck. Pushes it back, but Adam Fox is right there to clear. So unable to really set up. Riley drops it back for Hayhurst. Hayhurst has it bounce off his stick a little, but recovers it. He'll send it deep and chase. Bowman with it now. He'll try to set up at the point for Burgess, but it goes through Burgess's stick. Paul Bauer now. Paul Bauer stick handles. Gets it to Burgess. Engineers finally get it through for Whippen. Shot. Ken threw it in. Wait, bounces off the post. The light went on. No goal.
The referee was right there to wave no goal, but I wouldn't be surprised if they go take a look at this.
Yeah, I thought it hit the inside of the pipe.
I thought it hit the inside of the pipe, too. I think this is reviewable. We're looking at the replay right now.
So the shot bounces off a Whiffen stick.
Oh,
and now it bounces off the pipe.
Now looking at the replay, it was off the pipe. My apologies.
Good eye from the
referee. Good eye from the referee, so.
But a good chance there for the engineers again with another. With another 33 seconds left on this power play.
Yeah, from our angle, it looked like it was on the back of the net, but now looking at the replay, it clearly bounced off the pipe. So good job by the engineers, though, to get that pressure on there. No need to, Dave Smith wants to review too, but I don't know if he's gonna challenge this. It wouldn't be wise for him to challenge this.
So Whiffen takes the faceoff, and Bowman comes away with it. Bowman whips it around. Burgess keeps it in. Crimson able to clear. Paul Bauer skates up with it now. Drops it back for Burgess. Over to Hayhurst with some speed. Bowman will send it deep. Engineers running out of time on the power play. A good chance there from Brady Whiffen, but no cigar. Over to Johnson. Johnson sends it deep. Engineers, 8:16 to go. Have to tie it up. Fox with it behind his own net. Getting harassed there by Zeke. Now coming up with it is Dornbach. Dornbach gets it taken off a stick by Johnson. Riley backpedals, finds Gornal. Gornal tips it in. Taken again now by Marino. Puck goes high and out of play.
7:50 left to play in the second period. Harvard leading RPI by a score of 2-1 as Brady Whiffen just inches away from scoring the tying goal on a power play, but not a goal, so a smart no-call move by Dave Smith, as he would not have won that challenge.
Linden takes a faceoff, gets it into Leppinen. Polino with it now. Polino circles back. Polino gets it to Leppinen. Leppinen to the point. Over to Bear. Bear walks the line, gets a shot through, bounces around, and Clemson comes away with it. Shane Bear takes it back behind his own net, leaves it for Grant. Grant skates up. Sends it up there for Bear. Polino gets nothing from it. Crimson looked to push back. Taken back by Hallbauer. Bounces it off the stick of Laka, and it goes high.
Bounced off the netting, off the stick of Laka, bounced off the netting, so the puck will come back to neutral ice for a faceoff. Shots 29-20 right now in favor of Harvard. So RPI really needs this game here today if they want any chance of having home ice.
Fox with it now. Fox gets it back over to Rathbone. Rathbone sends it deep. Crimson pushing back. Let's get a shot through. Savory kicks it. Hayhurst pushes it to the back to the corner to safety. Crimson hold it in. Now sent in by Devereaux. Recover there by Ferner. Ferner skates up. Over to Hayers, who drops it for Lee. Lee plays give and go with Hayers. Lee sends it through. No one there, but a good centering attempt there from Tommy Lee. Lee tried to get up to the point for Riley, but it was intercepted there by the Crimson. Now moving up with it is Flutstrand, the captain. He'll drop it back. Hayers gets a stick on it, and now coming up is Johnson. Johnson stick handles. Will dump it in deep. Grant has it at the red line. He'll swing it around. Stop behind the net by Gournette. Marino gets put to the glass. A bear unable to hold it at the point. Tommy Grant now takes it by his own bench. Gets his pass intercepted by Dornbach. Drury skating with it now. Sends a pass over centers and gets it into the net. Jack Drury. A good give and go there from him and Bowlby. Really just a good play from both of them to take the two-goal lead here with 5:37 to go in the third.
Yeah, it was a good play from both of them, but it was also a poor defense, another defensive breakdown from RPI as, you know, Drury was allowed to skate right behind the defense. So the Winnetka, Illinois native, the draft pick over the Carolina Hurricanes, get a goal as Shane Bear came off of his man and took instead.
Skating up with it is Dornbach now. Crimson right back where they left off. Circling behind is Dornbach looking for a man. Decides to just send it in, but it gets blocked aside by his own teammate, Bowlby. Morello dumps it back for Ferner. Engineers look to reset. 5 minutes to go here. Engineers down two. Hallbauer. Circle. Finally decides to send it deep. Gournette leaves it behind the net. Now coming up with it is Kerfoot. Kerfoot will send it to the far corner. Riley battles for it. Johnson with it. Johnson circles back to, but it's taken off his stick. Flutstrand gets his shot blocked. Morello skates back up. Drops it back for Johnson. Johnson sends it, but it goes off the skate of Gornel. Gornel gets his own miss and will send it deep. Engineers change. Walsh pushes it high. Crimson trying to close out this game. 4 minutes to go. Tommy Grant, the captain. He'll send a stretch pass up for Laka. Laka sends it in, swings it around. Grant pushes it back in. Leppinen with it. Leppinen trying to find an open man. Gets it taken off his stick by Walsh. Linden with it. Linden and Leppinen trying to get some form of energy going for the engineers. Back up for Walsh. Over to Laka. Laka knocked off the puck. Marino with it. Marino sends it up. Crimson will skate out with it. Now coming up with his Crusco. Back over to Murphy. Murphy gets a shot. It goes up and over the net. Murphy with it again. Circles. Shot goes high. And bar down.
So 3:31 left to play in the third. Harvard takes a 4-1 lead over RPI as they get one past Savory.
Yeah, and just no life from this engineer team, and that's not a good thing. Yeah, I mean, they had every opportunity here tonight as they came out strong in that first period, but since the second period, they just have not looked like the team that we saw. It looked like they got a little complacent after getting the first goal, and that is not a good thing.
And right now, the stands are looking like the fire alarm went off again as the crowd can't get out of here fast enough.
So yeah.
4-1 left. 4-1 Harvard and RPI. So, barring a it says play under review, but I think this one would be.
Yeah, it's a good goal. It was a quick look.
Yeah. So 4-1 Harvard over RPI. And presumably this game is in the books.
Barring any crazy things, but we have seen crazy here at the Fieldhouse, including a fire alarm.
Yes.
Bowman with it now. He'll stick handle. Bowman drops it, gets it taken off his stick. Tommy Lee continuing to fight and pushing Donato around a little bit. Fox with it now. Fox, stick handles. Bowman whacking away, trying to get something started. Ferner with it behind his own net. He'll skate up, gain some speed. Goes to a side, bounces it off the boards, and is taken by the Crimson now. Now coming up with it is Dornbach. Dornbach, stick handles, moves in on Savory. Gets pushed into the boards by Grant and Bear. Moore now crushes a guy against the boards and shoves him to the ice. Moore just trying to start something here. Now Moore still going at it with Bowlby behind the play. Moore now takes it from behind his own net. He'll skate up. Gets it over to Grant. Grant will skate up with it. Grant looking to maybe get a little scoring going for tomorrow. Burgess with it. Burgess circles around the dot. Gets the point for Johnson. Johnson circles back. Shot goes through. Bounces around. And no. Moore with it. Gets taken off his stick there from Rathbone. Rathbone skates up. He'll send it deep to the near corner. It circles back towards the far corner. Up to Gornal at the half boards. He gets it, outlets to Moore. Moore sends it over to Johnson. Johnson will skate in again. Johnson showing a little bit of life late, but it gets taken off his stick. Riley with it now. Riley to Whiffen. Whiffen circles back, changes direction, bounces it off the boards, and plays give and go with Gornal. But no luck. Now coming up with it is Bandini. Bandini's backhander goes wide. Riley pushes him off. Gornal with it. Up to Johnson. Johnson again will send it deep and go off for a change. Whiffen pushes his man to the boards. Another hit there from Gornal. Hallbauer has it at the point. He'll skate in. Goes in towards the net, stops on the dime. Gets it up to the point there. Ferner with it, gets a shot through, bounces around from a block. With it behind the net is Bumbach. Now skating up is Devereaux. Devereaux sends it deep. Less than a minute here to go at the Houston Fieldhouse. You're listening to live coverage of RPI Hockey on 91.5 WRPI Troy. Gornal with it. Has it by the penalty box. Gets taken off a stick by Walsh. Walsh circles in, drops it back for Trumpstead, and it bounces off. Floodstrand's shot went wide. Crimson continuing to push as they have all game, and a shot goes through, but Savory pushes it aside. And so that's how this one will end. Crimson win 4-1. And really, it seems the fire alarm is gonna be the story of the night here, as the Engineers unable to come away with the victory in an all-important final ECAC hockey weekend.
Yeah, and you know, it's really too bad RPI came out on, pardon the pun, but on fire. And scored the goal on a power play, a great looking power play goal. But unfortunately after that, they
showed no energy
at all after that. And they lose this one 4-1. But some out of town scores for you. Not that it mattered, but Dartmouth and Union are tied at 3 going into overtime, as Union was up 3-1 on Dartmouth. Dartmouth scoring 2 extra attack goals in the final minute to tie that one up at 3. So Union and Dartmouth tied at 3, and then Clarkson and Colgate, Clarkson defeated Colgate 3-2. So the game switching in RPI's favor right now. And unfortunately, the game that didn't go RPI's way is the game that they actually had control over. So very unfortunate game, but RPI really came out, you know, in the first period, came out, scored a power play goal, and then after that, it was all Harvard. And, you know, we had a fire alarm in the building that you can blame that all you want, but...
No, it's just a disappointing showing here because they came out, they had a lot going for them. You have your two of your best players coming back, Polino and Hayhurst. And, I mean, Hayhurst certainly played well. He was up and down the ice, back-checking like a madman. But, I mean, just nothing really from the entire team that could change the event of this game, because it was just really not a good showing from them. Just I mean, it's upsetting because they've played well so far, like especially in the second half of the season, and they went toe to toe with this Crimson team not too long ago. They forced overtime, and I mean, Harvard ended up with the 3-2 victory, but they're coming off a weekend where they had two overtime games and they were able to win one of them. So even when they were down 2-1, you'd like to see them push back. And they almost did on that power play, but you can't depend on a power play to get you points. You need to be able to score a 5-on-5, which they have so far this year. But tonight was just, let's hope they don't come out like this tomorrow, because tomorrow, again, they're playing Dartmouth, and it's a team that they beat in overtime actually at their rink. Yeah. So it's a game that they certainly can win, and you hope they do.
Well, not only that, too, Joe, you just gave a great analysis, but going into the playoffs, now RPI is in a fight for 11th. They lose the tiebreaker with Princeton. So, you know, depending on how the game falls, they could be going, they could be in 11th, you know. So it's just a matter of, they'll definitely be on the road. It's just a matter of where they're going. Will they go to Hamilton? Will they go to Schenectady? Or now Providence is in the picture, Brown.
Yeah, which so, they have not done well against Brown this year. Gavin Nieto has had their number, so.
Yeah, and Brown has had their number for the last couple of years in RPI hockey. So if you have to go to Providence, you have to go to Providence and do what you can. But like we said at the beginning, you'd rather stay as close to home as possible, you know, with everything going on, with breaks, with exams coming up and blah, blah, blah. So, and you've had success against Colgate and Union, and you go in there with confidence knowing that you can beat those teams and you haven't beaten Brown. So, yes, you should go in with confidence
on any
that
team,
you can beat any team, but you haven't had luck
easier
for the past, you know, 6-7 years against a team you could possibly be playing in their barn at the playoffs. And not to mention, too, RPI has always, it seems like RPI always plays Brown in the playoffs. It's just a matter of Brown has bounced RPI at the Fieldhouse. So
yeah.
Brown has just had RPI's number. So if you go into Providence, you go in, hopefully you can turn the tides against Brown, but you just got to take care of what you can take care of tomorrow, and that's
get a win for yourself as
good as positioning as possible, and the rest will fall into place and you get momentum going into the playoffs. Tonight was not the game to do it. You come out tomorrow like this, it's going to be the same result. If you come out the same way tomorrow.
Yeah. I mean, they came out correctly, but you got to finish. You got to play 60 minutes.
Correct.
You got to play 60 minutes, and they did not play 60 minutes tonight. They played about 20 minutes, and then they went up to the ECAV locker room, I guess, and just sort of got too comfortable. So.
And Union just won in overtime, so... RPI would have been on the road regardless if they had taken the victory here today, but you know, you still want to get the victory. You don't know if you know,
yeah,
you don't know
you
what was going
to
happen
the
there. But unfortunately for RPI, they didn't take the victory. They go on the road. Now it's just a matter of, do you go to Schenectady, Hamilton, or Providence?
So
I will think of my offensive and defensive players of the game, and Joe, you want to run down scoring, and we'll get those out of here.
Yeah, so... Engineers started off the scoring in the first period off of a power play goal from Chase Zeke. And then coming back with it were the Harvard Crimson in the second period off of a goal from...
Hold on, we'll get this fired
yeah,
up.
It was...
We were unprepared here. We just got the stat sheet, so...
It was in the second period.
Yeah, we'll get the scoring here for you.
I believe it was Dornbach on the power play.
Yes, it was Dornbach.
And then I believe it was Rathbone again.
Yep.
In the second period.
And then
it was
Drury, and then it was Murphy for Harvard getting
Yeah, Drury, and then Murphy, who didn't get too many shifts tonight, but the ones he did, he made sure they went well.
So that will, we were unsure of the times on that goal. The one by Drury was 14:23 of the third, and then 16:29 of the third was the one by Murphy. So we are that, and my, I guess my offensive engineer of the game, I'll give to Chase Zeke. He got the only goal of the game. And then I guess my defensive engineer of the game, I'll give to Tommy Grant, just because he kept that one goal on the power
really
play.
Impressive.
He played really well. And he gets it there. Honorable mention goes to Owen Savory. I mean, three of the goals weren't.
Certainly not his best
certainly
night.
Certainly not his best night, but certainly not his fault either. The one goal just bounced off the official's legs and was left open in the middle. So, but Tommy Grant and Chase Zeke, and that will do it. We'd like to thank, before we get off the air, we'd like to thank the Rensselaer Union, which provides the funding for WRPI and all club-related activity of the Institute, including WRPI's coverage of RPI men's and women's ice hockey, football, and baseball. We'd also like to thank you for listening on the World Wide Web. Point your browser to www.wrpi.org, and you can hear a broadcast 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, so long as we are broadcasting. We will provide the broadcast on the internet feed. Once again, it is www.wrpi.org. We'd also like to thank Dan Wakefield back at the studio for getting us on the air and for taking over the broadcast during the fire alarm and then getting us back on the air again. So not usually a busy night for our inboarders, but tonight it was a very busy night. So we'd like to thank you for doing that and staying there and answering the phone through all the confusion and all that stuff. So that will do it. The score here after three periods of play, Harvard 4, RPI 1. That's your final score for Joe Piscano. I'm Ed DeGuerin. You've been listening to live coverage of RPI Hockey on 91.5 FM, WRPI, Troy.